Hello everyone, my name is Aurav Kansupada, and today I'll be telling my own story I wrote, Differences. There is no place on earth like my school. It's the only place where insanity rules. I mean, the teachers are normal, but the kids aren't. They're different and very weird. I may be the only normal kid on campus. Well, you may be wondering, how are these kids weird? Well, let me give you an example of Linda McCheesy. You see, the McCheeseys love photography. In fact, every single member of the McCheesy family is a professional photographer. A few weeks ago, we went to their house for dinner, and we took our professional camera to take a photo. My mom insists we should take our memories with an actual camera, but that camera was 30 pounds and I was not happy. Anyway, when we reached there, our camera was sadly turned to dust. The second we got in, I was just holding a big glob of dust that soon faded away. We now know that the McCheesys destroyed our camera. Well, my little brother was very mad and he called 911. But he called the paramedics. I don't think they were happy when they saw the scene. Anyway, I'm a lone wolf at school. I have no friends, no buddies, nothing. I rely on only myself and that's it. But however, things change and it surely did for me. A few weeks ago, I came to school as normal, watching out for anything falling from the sky. I'm not joking, a few kids like to hurl bricks and other objects. I reached my school where the Greek club awaited us. They're the cruelest of the cruelest that tease and bully you real bad. The only way to avoid them is to enter from the cafeteria doors. But I guess others had my idea. It was a 20-minute wait. And when I got in, it was 10 minutes past the bell. I guess my mom won't be happy receiving that letter. Anyway, after class, I was walking down the hallways when I saw something amazing. A normal person who wasn't being weird or goofing off. He was at his locker when I tapped him on the shoulder. He turned around and I saw his name tag, Dog. What I saw next was unexplainable. His face was deformed. No, it was ugly, grotesque. No amount of plastic surgeries could ever fix it. I guess I did a horrible job hiding my astonishment as I fainted on the spot. I woke up a few minutes later with a jug of water on my face. I got up and saw the crystal blue eyes of my principal. He began, "I think you should go apologize to Dog. He seems very hurt after what you did." I obeyed and quickly ran outside where I found Dog on a bench, crying his heart out. I got up, tapped him on the shoulder, and asked, "Are you okay? I'm sorry about what I did." He got up and said, "No, it's fine. They always do it," and left. Later during class, our teacher gave us a massive load of homework that was due the next day. It would take the entire day, and I was really sad. Later on the walk home, I saw a true act of compassion by Dog. As I was walking through the woods, I saw a child riding his bike across branches, roots, and shrubs. But suddenly, his bike hit a root, and he went flying. He was badly injured and wounded. I saw a Dog run up and pick him up, trying to carry him all the way back to his house. I knew this was a fateful decision. It would take Dog an hour at least to return to his house. And then he would have to finish his really big homework assignment. And so I watched, and then I had to go home, knowing I could not waste any more time. Later that night, my mom came and she told me, "Hey, did you know that this kid named Dog went and helped an injured child all the way to your aunt's house? It was a shame he reached his house at 6:30 p.m. Now I should try to finish that massive homework assignment." I nodded, amazed at this act of kindness. Next day, Dog was honored at his act of compassion. And I had been thinking, if I could make Dog my friend, everybody needs a friend, even me. And I thought I'd find the perfect one. Dog would stand by me in times of need and help me whenever things got tough. You should always judge a person by their pages inside instead of their cover outside. Later at lunch, I asked Dog, "Would you like to be my friend?" A smile spread across his face, and I knew I'd found a friend for life. Thank you. The moral of the story is, always judge a person by their pages inside instead of their cover outside. Thank you.